For me, one of the most interesting things that's happened with AI in the last week has been Microsoft's announcement that it's going to support these chat tools through its cloud platform. Because in my experience at Microsoft, it thinks very, very hard around these implications, right? I mean, I trust Brad's team to have been thoughtful about this. And I'm quite curious, I'm sorry to take your role for a second, Nicholas, but I'm quite curious about the thought process that went on in Microsoft, given that you know that we're all sitting here saying this could destroy democracy, to make this thing broadly available. Because I trust your thinking, I'd just love to hear what it was.
Well, we have a responsible AI infrastructure that is similar to what we have for privacy, security, and digital safety. And by that, we have principles, a policy, we have an organizational infrastructure, there is training, there is testing, there are engineering tools. You know, there's work that goes on before a product is released. There's a testing of it afterwards. There's a whole compliance regimen. You know, so, you know, we do feel good, for example, not only about the API we released or announced on Monday was coming, including with access to the same technology as ChatGPT, even though that's going to advance very substantially, very quickly this year, as well as what it will mean, as Satya Nadella said, you know, to integrate this into all of our first-party products, the operating system, application, search, all of these things, and we'll continue to have all of these controls. And really building on your point before, which I think is really quite important, you know, one of the huge advances that comes from this is the ability of, say, enterprise customers, government, NGO, business, to use it with their own data sets. You know, and I think in some ways, ChatGPT has gotten everybody so focused on one aspect of this, the generative AI, which I think should be a great tool for creative expression. There's the other side of this, which is, call it fact-finding, a great tool for critical thinking, mm-hmm. so that people can find new insights, discover new facts. And all of that requires controls, and, you know, we've all gotten so excited, which is amazing on the one hand, with a beta release that, you know, we haven't yet seen the finished product. And because I get to work every day with the internal builds at Microsoft, you know, I'll be the first to say that in October, you know, when I was using what you are using today, I was like, whoa, I'm not sure we've thought through everything. And now it's the middle of January, and I'm like, I am feeling like we're in much better shape to address the kinds of concerns that you're talking about, and we'll be in even better shape when these things go live.